Today we're going to talk about the software that you're going to start to learn, or what 3D programs that you should learn in order to start your 3D journey. Number one, for beginners. If you are a complete beginner, or if you are new to 3D, then I recommend using Blender, because it is a software that is completely free and it is constantly developed by professional artists and developers that are trying to make it better every year, and we've seen a significant growth in this software, and it is actually competing with the other paid software in the marketplace. The good thing about starting with Blender is the fact that it is completely free. You don't have to pay anything for the experience. Also, trying to work in 3D using Blender is going to give you important information about how 3D software work. Also, the other commercial software like 3ds Max, Maya, give a 30-day trial, but it is nowhere close to having all the time you want to try 3D software, which Blender can provide. Of course, there are a lot of people who are excited for 3D, and when they try it, probably they are going to discover that it is not their thing, and having Blender is going to allow you to taste the waters for free as long as you want. Blender can be used for lots of things like creating video games, working on VFX for movies, and creating animation for film. It is also a good tool for sculpting and other important functions that come handy when necessary, because Blender is really a Swiss knife type of 3D software. Unfortunately, Blender is not industry standard, meaning that it is not part of production pipelines in video game development, VFX studios, or even animation studios, for lots of reasons, like the fact that pipelines are kind of tough to change, and it is hard to recruit people who actually have professional experience working in the industry using Blender, because there are not a lot of them working in the industry in the first place. And also the focus of studios on quality rather than the tools they are using or how much it costs them, because to be honest, it is not significant compared to the other costs they have to pay in order to move the production forward. But regardless of this fact, Blender is a great starting point, and you can work using it professionally on your own as a freelancer, or if you want to work in a studio, then you already have the experience, and switching software is not going to be that big of a deal, because experience is artist related rather than software related, so to speak. Number two, animation. When it comes to animation, there is actually one software that stands on the top, and it is Autodesk Maya. This software has been used by top animation studios for decades now, because it is simply efficient and it is equipped with amazing tools for doing animation specifically. Among these studios are Pixar and DreamWorks, and these studios have been literally creating new tools for making the process of doing animation faster and more efficient, so they can squeeze the most out of it. Also, Autodesk has been developing the software over the years, which made it better overall, even though the development kind of slowed down in recent years. Blender can be a good software for animation too, and it is actually competing with Maya when it comes to this. It is really good for rigging as well and other 3D animation stuff. So if you want to test animation, then you can start with Blender. And if you are sure that you want to work in animation studios, then you probably need to start learning Maya from the start. But to be honest, Maya is standard software for animation in the industry, and the other software like 3ds Max, Modo, Cinema 4D, and some of the other software can do animation as well, and they are very good at it. But Maya is kind of the agreed upon software. This is known in this industry, and if this is not common knowledge for you, then now you know. Number three, video game development. For video game development, there are actually lots of choices that you can choose from, and they all have proven to be very good software when it comes to generating amazing results in creating video games. You can choose between Maya, 3ds Max, Modo, Cinema 4D, or Blender. The difference between commercial software like 3ds Max and Maya in game development and Blender is that the commercial software are used for professional AAA game development studios like Blizzard, Bethesda, Electronic Arts, and so on. And Blender, on the other hand, as a free and open source software, is heavily used by indie developers because they have limited budget. Also, they have more experience with Blender, and they can hire like-minded people that have the same experience and they have the same passion for game development. If you know that you are going to work for indie game developers or in indie game development, then you can start right away with Blender. And if you want to work on AAA video games in a large studio, then you can start learning 3ds Max or Maya, because these two are kind of the professional game development industry standard software that is being used currently in the industry. Or if you can afford it, then you can start with Blender to learn the basics of game development, like modeling, animation, texturing, and how to use a game engine. Then you can switch to 3ds Max or Maya in order to get hired for a AAA game development studio in the future. And of course, there are lots of resources out there to learn these softwares when it comes to game development, whether paid or free, because there is no shortage when it comes to this. Number four, effects. For effects in general and VFX specifically, there are a few softwares that stand on top, and those are Autodesk Maya, Autodesk 3ds Max, Houdini, and also Cinema 4D to a certain extent. So basically, each VFX studio is using one of these software to create amazing shots. Of course, some of these software use plugins and tools, and all of these softwares are very good because they deliver amazing results. But in recent years, with the development of Nodes, Houdini kind of stood up from the crowd because it uses node-based technology, which made it powerful, and VFX artists can do everything and anything they throw at it. Unlike the other 3D animation software, Houdini uses a node-based procedural workflow that makes it easy to explore iterations as you refine your work. Programs like 3ds Max, Maya, or Blender store changes in the user history, which makes it difficult to return to previous versions of your work. Houdini's unique node-based approach allows for multiple iterations so that it is easy to make changes and develop your animation and effects. Also, Houdini is best known for advanced dynamic simulation tools, which allows for the creation of highly realistic visual effects. Putting Houdini here on a pedestal does not mean that it is the ultimate software and the others are trash. No, actually, lots of VFX studios right now are using 3ds Max and Maya heavily and Cinema 4D to generate amazing results and create amazing films. So we're saying here that Houdini is kind of the leading software, but it does not mean that the others are not effective and are not used in the industry. Number five, visualization. When it comes to visualization, there is one software that stands on top among those we mentioned before, which is 3ds Max. It is famous among architects, designers, and look developers because it is basically developed by Autodesk, which has lots of tools integrated with it that you can use in order to create amazing interior and exterior scenes. If you don't know, Autodesk gets only 10% of its revenue from entertainment software like 3ds Max and Maya. The rest, 90%, is engineering and architecture stuff and things of that sort. Autodesk is a corporation that generates $3 billion a year, and only 10% of it is generated from entertainment software, and 3ds Max is kind of chosen to have some of that engineering technology and architecture technology integrated with it for doing interior and exterior visualization, and it became the best at it. People can create amazing scenes and renders using 3ds Max and what it offers, and they can do it in a very efficient and deliver great results. Also, the other software like Blender, Maya, Modo, Cinema 4D can do visualization as well, but they were not specifically created for having this function and that purpose in mind. Also, what makes 3ds Max a better candidate for this job is the number of plugins they can be integrated with it that have been developed over the years that make the process easier and faster, and there are a lot of them actually. So if you are interested in creating houses, cities, interior scenes, or environments for rendering and presentation purposes, then 3ds Max is going to be the software for you to choose. To be honest, there are a lot of 3D software in the marketplace, and making a choice without having the right knowledge about what you are choosing is going to literally cost you time and money in the future, and you're probably afraid of making the wrong choice that will make you end up with something that isn't going to be something that you're going to be able to work with perfectly and generate the most from as a 3D artist. What we talked about here is not intended to put a piece of software on a pedestal as a king that cannot be overthrown or alienate some of the 3D programs, because this is not the intention here. The purpose behind this breakdown is to emphasize points of strength for the best 3D programs that we have today, and how you can choose one based on your interest and in which field you want to work in the future, whether it be in animation, video games, or feature film and VFX. I hope you've got a clear idea from what we talked about here, because it is important to know what each 3D program is best used for to help you make a better decision that can be useful for you long term. You can tell us your thoughts in the comment section below. Also, you can check some of our previous videos. Thank you very much, and I will see you in the next one.